when I saw her, she had a fair skin with pretty eyes, and so she caught my eye. And right from then on, I think I have this crush on her. Every time she's on duty, I really make it to a point that I would be on duty also.
Sometimes I start to wonder why he's always the one who answers my calls. Every time I refer a patient, it's always him. Every time we have to transfer a patient to another hospital, it's always him in the van. It's like, oh, but I didn't want to assume anything. Maybe he was just really the one on duty. But he was doing that on purpose.
Yes. We had the bowling game. I think that bowling game
started everything.
Yes.
Because it was that taxi ride going home that led from one event to another.
We took a taxi ride and I decided to
be a gentleman and offered to escort me to my house,
yes,
which you did. And when we reached the gate, you wanted to have a cup of, to drink a glass of water, which I couldn't refuse. So I invited you in, and I think that was the start of the longest conversation I had with someone. And after that, everything else unfolded. Rex is a man of few words. He likes to give me cards, like long cards with very long messages, but what he writes in it is just, "Dear me, love Rex."
I think there is this patience of looking into cards, like read through the cards, and the message of these cards reflect what I feel.
I love the shape of your mouth, I love the taste of your lips, I love the way you pull me into you, and I melt when you're holding my hips.
After 2 years of our relationship, she had to work overseas.
It was very hard on the first 2 years.
From being a couple that sees almost every day, then all of a sudden you were being separated all of a sudden.
So after 2 years of not being together, we decided to go to Singapore. And since I was assuming that he was going to propose there, I tried to help him a bit by taking him to places wherein I know which would be a bit romantic, so then he can pop the question to me. The first one, we had to go to a floating restaurant, because then I thought it would be a very romantic place for him to pop the question. But we finished through our meal, but still no question. But I said, okay, this is still day one. There can still be day two. So the next day, I tried to bring him again to another restaurant, but we just finished our meal and still no question. So third day, we went to the flyer.
When we were in the flyer, it was I was supposed to really pop the question there.
During our turn, it just so happened that we shared the capsule with another couple. So I think that
spoiled
his plan.
So
we got back into the hotel.
Yeah, we got back to the hotel, and I think I spoiled her day, because it wasn't the
gift that I was expecting.
She was expecting.
When you opened the box, I expected to see a ring, like a single ring. But when I opened it, it was a set, like earring, necklace, and a ring. So I had to tell him, what is this for? Is this a gift? And then he said, actually, that's your engagement ring. So I had to tell him, an engagement is supposed to come alone and not with a set.
It was supposed to be an engagement ring, but you know, men, we don't know things. We don't know what gifts are.
And then he told me, oh well, for now, just accept it as engagement ring, and then I'll give you another ring later on. 'Cause you are, you are, you
2010 that I proposed right in front of their house.
So he had to do another proposal, this time with the correct ring, and he did it on Valentine's Day in front of my parents' house in Kalsangi, and that was the proper proposal, and of course I said yes. You take a knee and I can see what you're asking me, and I do, I do, I do. I belong to you. Oh, we can't get any better than this. You stole at me with your perfect kiss. And I know, I know, I know you have waited for. I've always dreamed of becoming a doctor, but since I didn't end up being one, I said I'll marry one. So here he is, I'm marrying a doctor. I belong to you.